Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I'm not sure what time you will be joining me on this pre-recorded join lesson, but regardless of the time, I'm glad you are able to take a moment to get outside of your crazy schedule and take some time to be creative. I do apologize for the lighting. As the time changes, I discovered that I need to adjust some of the lighting in this room. So hopefully it won't be too difficult for you to follow along. Today, I would like to do some seasonal drawings with you. And I'm not going to put any music on in the background because I want to invite you to include some meditative type music with your drawing exercise today. And whatever that music may be, some of us do better with nice calming sounds in the background. Some of us actually do quite well with just good old-fashioned rock and roll. So please go ahead and take some time to put some music on because I'm going to talk very lightly, hopefully not be too intrusive in your drawing experience. I am going to be walking you through, like I said, a seasonal drawing. But first, I'd like to introduce myself. My name is Cecilia Bianchi. Oh, I noticed that we are filming backwards, so that's not going to work. And you know what? I'm not really in the mood right now to learn how to draw my name backwards, but my name is Cecilia Bianchi, and I am one of your advisors, or your, I should say, drawing instructors for the Oasis. And hopefully you will find this to be a nice, peaceful meditative experience. We are going to be drawing pumpkins. So pumpkins are something that we see pop up this time of year. And but we're going to do a little twist on the pumpkin. We are going to create some fun Zentangle patterns in the pumpkin. But first, let's go ahead and get started with the initial design of the pumpkin. I'm going to ask you to make sure you have a piece of paper in front of you and a pencil with an eraser, because we are going to, every once in a while, make some oopsies and want to correct that, making sure that our drawing looks the best that we are capable of doing. So if your drawing does not look like my drawing, I would not expect it to, only because you're the one drawing it, right? So I tell all my middle school students, it can't look identical to mine because that is my drawing. But I am going to talk you through drawing a pumpkin with us today. So let's go ahead and focus on where we want to begin our drawing. I'm going to start the center of my paper. I'm going to just draw a line here because I want to make sure that I don't go beyond that line. I want to keep my pumpkin within this space. And the first shape I'm going to create is going to be the center of the pumpkin. So this particular shape kind of reminds me of a soda bottle, like a 2-liter soda bottle. I'm going to start with a curve at the top. Bring it down. Create a curve at the bottom. And then go back up. It's going to be our center of our pumpkin. Now I'm going to start with our left. Now the left side of the pumpkin, I'm going to start with a curved line here and take it to the left. Bring it down just before the bottom, like that. And once again, I'm going to do another one on the center, on the left side. Starting again up here, the very top of that curved line I created before. Bringing it down just before we get to the bottom. We're going to do the exact same thing on the right side of our pumpkin. First, I'm going to go ahead and erase some lines that I don't want to see anymore. My reference lines. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and create another curved line here. Bringing it down. Curve it into the pumpkin before we get to the bottom. Once again, we've got another one that's going to start at the top of our curve. bring it down, and in our pumpkin. Now we have a full looking pumpkin, right? At least the front side of it. At the top, we're going to go ahead and do a little bit of a stem. And the stem is going to start over here. I'm going to go towards the center, curve up and to the left. Like that. I'm going to top it off with a little line right there. I apologize for the sounds of the streets. Didn't realize how loud my street was. And the stem here, I am going to bring it down and curve to the right like that. And now we have the stem. Erase my reference lines. And we're not quite done because we do want to give the illusion that this is a full pumpkin. So we need to create some curves in the back, like a little upside down happy face here and here. And hopefully that allows us to look like we have created a full pumpkin. Now what I want to do with our pumpkins, because I want you to be able to express some of that creativity that sometimes does get stifled when we are working too diligently with our left side of our brain, I want to go ahead and create some Zentangles within this pumpkin. And I'm not sure if you're familiar with Zentangles, but Zentangles is a new, well, the past couple of years, type of drawing technique that was created that helps us to explore mindful drawing. They're similar to doodles, but doodles where they might be mindless, like you might just go with the flow on your paper. Zentangles are more mindful, and they're more mindful patterns. So we're going to create some fun patterns within these pumpkin shapes. I'm going to start with one of my favorite patterns that I do all the time in my drawings, and those are swirls. So I'm going to start with the center one. I'm just going to just do some swirls like this. If swirls are not your cup of tea, then I recommend you choose any pattern to put in here. Changing up the sizes. Changing up the direction. Tight patterns to leave less space in between my pattern designs. Now I noticed I've been creating tighter patterns here, and I started off with a very loose pattern. I might want to go inside and create one more line so it looks more uniformed. And there you have it. You have your first shape in your pumpkin with a pattern. Now, let's see here. I think what I'd like to do on this side is I'm going to create something a little less curvy and a little bit more with some sharper edges. So I'm going to introduce some triangles, but these triangles do have some curve to them. Remembering that you can do any size you want. Feel free to add some curves to them if you'd like. Loving that one. You'll see me do that every once in a while. But I don't want any one particular shape to dominate another one. So if it looks too out of shape, I tend to fix it. Okay, so we have some sharp contrasts and shapes. On this side over here, I'm going to do something a little bit looser. I'm going to create some circles, different sizes, and incorporate some lines with it. So I'm going to do some circles first. When I do circles, I do it very lightly, and I kind of do a bunch of circles until I see the actual solid circle emerge. Thank you. little too similar. So I'm going to create a different size there. And as I mentioned before, I wanted to incorporate some lines in here. As I mentioned before, feel free to put any patterns that you feel comfortable that you might find yourself creating when you're on those long lecture classes or in those corporate meetings. Okay, so let's go back to this side. I think what I'd like to do is do a pattern just focusing on diagonal lines. So I'm going to start right here and do some curvy, loose diagonal lines. But I'm not done. I now want to cross them, intersect them. So let's see, starting here. Almost like a whimsical checker pattern. Now if you'll notice, I'm drawing with a heavy pencil, so my lines are dark. Should have mentioned this before, but I encourage you to draw very lightly in case you don't exactly love the line that you drew and you wanted to erase it. And it doesn't leave any ghost lines. Okay. So now we have like a very whimsical checkered line over here. I think what I'd like to do over here is create something that looks more like flower, that type of a natural design. So I'm going to go ahead and start with a circle, and daisies are one of my favorite flowers. So I'm going to go ahead and create some like designs that look very similar to daisies, but not necessarily a full daisy. I love to draw designs that go off the page. Every once in a while you'll see me do that. Feel free to incorporate outside your negative space outside your drawing into your art. Okay. Seems to be a little bit of space here. We do see a little bit of this and this. So I'm going to go ahead and add some designs in here too that so we don't feel like we've left out entirely. Let's see here. What do I want to do? I think maybe I'll just do some repetition of some lines. A simple zigzag line design. Like that. Also make it a little bit more fun and include some circles in there. I could see that. Okay. And then we've got one more space. Let's see here. How about some simple dashed lines? Or actually, you know what? This looks kind of groovy. I'm doing like a loose string pattern here. Okay. You could include some designs in your stem if you like. I think maybe I will do just a simple line. And as I go up the stem, curve them and then curve them towards the end. Okay, now we can actually begin with some coloring. Now these are pumpkins, so we are gonna stay around the basic color of pumpkins. So if you want, but feel free to also, like I said earlier, create your own design and use some more whimsical colors. I'm going to stick around the oranges, browns, tans, blacks. Let me go ahead and pull the colors out and we can start to begin. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to start over here. I mentioned to you that I was doing like a loose pattern design, and I think that's, I'm sorry, a loose pattern checker design. And I think that's what I'm going to do is color these in with, let's see what color do I want. I think I'm going to go for like a dark brown. Not necessarily black, but a dark brown. And I'm going to color them in like little checkers. Oops. We won't finish coloring in our design today. We're going to run out of time. But feel free to take some moments during your schedule during the week and just allow yourself some coloring time. And this is when you don't have to be thinking about much other than doing your best work. Kind of pull that young child from within and just enjoy the coloring process. I'm doing a traditional checker with very deep colors, leaving a white blank shape in between. But if you wanted to experiment by doing something like this, where just on the outside of the checker piece, I almost colored the wrong one. Oops. If you wanted to do a dark frame, and then just gradually get lighter within a medium frame, and then a light frame. So if you wanted to do something like that, it always looks good too. So I'll show a little bit more about how to do that. I'm not too concerned that I outlined this one accidentally, because we would go back. We will go back and outline all of the lines. I usually do that after the fact, because then it covers up any oopsies I might have done if I went outside the shape. I'll go ahead and demonstrate again how you do the outer dark, to medium, to medium light, to light. Medium, medium light, and then light. So that's two different ways you can do it. I'm going to go back to my dark. I have to take a quick little pencil sharpen break. depending on the name brand of your color pencil, I don't recommend necessarily using your hand like I have been because it might smear. Okay. Let's see. Now what I wanted to demonstrate on this particular one is how I'm going to color the negative space, which is the space that does not occupy a shape, a different color than the actual physical space, which is in this case the triangles. Okay, so I think I'm going to do the background, the negative space, in orange. And this one's kind of a bright orange. I'm going to probably choose a different orange to go inside the shapes. I mentioned earlier, we may not have time to complete the entire coloring project, but I'm just going to demonstrate a couple of different techniques you can use when you choose to color. And then that'll be up to you, and you can choose to finish coloring it. And you just need a little brain break. This is what I usually do when I need a brain break. I save the coloring parts for that particular moment where I just need to decompress and not think about anything other than which color would I like to put here. So if you don't want to disturb your coloring, if you're using coloring pencils, there's a couple of things you can do. You could have started, so I'm right-handed, so if my hand actually started on my left side of my drawing and worked this way, then I wouldn't disturb the coloring, but I kind of wanted to show you this first. So what I might do here now is I'll take a piece of paper, I'll take a tissue and put it here so I can rest my hand while coloring this, and then I won't smear my colors. People just love to drive by my house like that. Your hand is gone. There we go. Not trying to rush and make less mistakes when I rush. Go very slowly. Okay, so I'd like to go ahead and color in my positive space shapes. A different color, but keeping it within the color scheme of what we're doing here for fall. So what I might do is incorporate some lighter brown than I used for the over here. You know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking you might want to go for like an orange red. Orange red. Okay, so I'm going to use a red. Maybe I will add some brown in there too. I'm not sure where I want to go with this, so I'm going to color in my spaces pretty light red. I think I might overlap with another color. I think I might overlap with brown. A little dark around the outline and light on the inside. I like to use colored pencils, but if you like to use markers, you can still overlap colors with markers. What you can do is you can use, you can put a base with a marker down. Like we could have easily done a marker in the background here with the orange. And then depending on the type of paper, sometimes you'll have to, the marker will have to dry. Some markers dry immediately if it's a thicker paper. And then after the marker is dry, you can go ahead and color over that with a colored pencil with a different color and give it a nice different look with mixing your colors, overlapping colors. I think I'm going to overlap some browns with this red here. And I'm just going to do it in the corners. Not towards the center, but I don't think the video looks as good as the person. You guys notice that? Our time's coming to a close, actually. I just noticed we're coming up on the 50-minute mark. But we're going to keep going for a little bit because I want to show what this looks like. On your other parts of your pumpkin, feel free to do, you know, any color scheme you want. I'm sticking with my fall colors. I'm going to add some yellows and some more oranges and reds and browns. Do some overlapping colors, kind of like I'm doing here. Just for fun, I'm going to go ahead and add a yellow in the middle. Actually, this is more like a yellow orange. I'm going to show you how to add that, like right here. Not sure if it, no, it does show up a little bit. It's very subtle. When you add colors on top of each other, it's very subtle. It gives it a like a dimensional look. Whenever you add colors, like you overlap colors, I know it takes extra time, but it really does make it look kind of special. Unique. Not so flat, you know? Not so flat. This orange yellow in the middle. I'm going to show you one more thing and then we're going to have to finish for the today. But I encourage you to keep working at this drawing, regardless of me being in the background. So, what I think I want to do is I want to show you how to do a very thin, and you can use a thin Sharpie, or I'm using a colored pencil. This is black. Try and do a thin line around these shapes. Help them pop. And cover any pencil mark And I might not have colored over. And lose it with like this clean finish. But it should be thin, so it might mean having to sharpen your pencil halfway through. Sometimes the Sharpies don't always work over the colored pencils because colored pencils are a little waxy. So this pretty much is our class for today. And like I said, I encourage you to continue coloring or leave it for a time where you're a little stressed or you need something to just take your mind off of all of the left brain activities that we're doing on a daily basis. Please enjoy my videos. And once again, I encourage you to play some music in the background. Just create like a nice little event for yourself. So I'm going to finish this on my own, but I do wish you all the best of luck, and I hope you enjoyed our first fall drawing of the semester, working with this decorative Zentangle pumpkin. Thank you all very much, and see you soon.